Hey guys, welcome back to Hike Oregon. Today is just going to be a very quick video showing you guys the book that I wrote. If you've been following me for a while, you will know that I've been working on a book for the last year and a half, and it is finally done. I'm so excited. Here it is. So it's 52 hikes for 52 weeks in the Willamette Valley, Central Cascades, and Central Coast area. So if you live in Oregon, you'll know what those areas entail. If you have no idea about Oregon, stay tuned. I will show you what the book looks like and everything like that. This is just the front cover here. Then there's the spine there. And then the back. Basically, why I created this book is because I personally have struggled with finding the perfect hike for that specific season. I know a lot of people love summer and fall backpacking here in Oregon because it's easy to just go out and find a hike to do. There's no snow to worry about, and you can pretty much go anywhere without any limitations. However, winter and spring are a totally different story, and a lot of people stop hiking because they just don't know where to go. So I created this book for that specific reason. So in this book, there's one hike per week, and it is a hike that you can do for that exact week of the year. It's especially cool for those of you who want to do the 52 hike challenge. You can basically just get this book and go through it, and you'll never have to think about where am I gonna go next weekend? You know, where's the snow? What's the weather? This will map it all out for you. But even if you're not doing the 52 hike challenge, this is still a great book and anyone can use it because it lays out the hike in order of season. So let me turn the camera around and I will show you the layout of the book and kind of how you can use it.
Okay, so here is the cover of the book, and then you flip open and there's my dedication, table of contents. Again, table of contents here, and then just a little bit about the book, why I wrote it, my difficulty ratings, and then what to pack. I have a little pack list. And then here I have Leave No Trace principles. And then we start the book here. So here's winter, and here's the first hike. So this is what the layout looks like. I'll bring it a little bit closer here so you can see. I have mileage, approximate hike time, difficulty, trail type, trail usage, highest elevation and lowest elevation of the hike, the area that the hike is in, suggested seasons, and then of course the best season. If you need a wilderness permit, if you need a parking permit, if there's a pit toilet, and if the trail allows different things. So it'll either allow dogs, camping, skiing, mountain bikes, etc. And then I have directions from all of the major cities here in Oregon. So I always have directions from Eugene, Portland, Bend, and Medford. And then on this page here, you see the map that I have here. And then the trail description starts. So for each hike, I have 1 to 2 photos. So here's 2 photos for this hike here. And then at the end of each hike, I have other nearby trails and closest campgrounds. So then you basically just go through the book. So you see week 3, then you see week 4. As obviously some hikes are, you know, have more pages than others. Week 5, week 6, and so on and so forth, right? So that's the premise of the book here. It's not super complicated, but it is really nicely laid out. I think I did a pretty good job with the layout of it, and you know, different pictures, and the maps turned out really, really nicely. Actually, I was very pleasantly surprised with that. And then I do want to show you in the back, I guess this is the other difference between the two books. So the book without page numbers also doesn't have this little back map. I did add that later. Someone suggested that this is actually really important. So I did actually add a map here and some more pages to the book. The book without page numbers actually has 222 pages. This one has a few more because of this map that I made. So it basically shows the entire area that this book encompasses and the major towns and the major highways that I mention in the book. And then here it has campground information. So all of the campgrounds that you saw me mention at the end of each hike, they are alphabetically listed on this back section. I do have like if the sites are walk up, how many sites can have campers, what the price is, vault toilet, if there's electrical hookup, what dates the campgrounds are open, etc. So this is actually really nice and helpful because a lot of people like to camp near where they hike. This whole thing is a few pages of campground info, and then I have my little about the author thing here, and then I have some hiking notes. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I guess 6 pages of blank right here for hiking notes. So if you have any notes for specific hikes or a, you know, wish list or gear list or whatever you want to put here, this is for you to write in. So yeah, that is the entire book.
So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions about the book, just comment below. I'll be more than happy to answer them. So I do have 2 purchasing options for this book. If you haven't been following me on any other social media, you may not know the story of the misprint book order. So the first order of books that I printed, 225 books, were misprinted by the company. They don't have page numbers and they don't have this writing on the spine here. So that is blank. And then the book doesn't have page numbers, which obviously is kind of a big deal because there is an index referring to page numbers. So, but you can write the page numbers in the book. However, people had pre-ordered these books. Obviously, they need page numbers, so I reordered those for the people that pre-ordered books. So I do still have a few of these books left, and I do have quite a bit of the misprinted books as well, which I'm selling for a very discounted price, obviously, because there's no page numbers and you'll have to number them yourself, which sucks. The company was not easy to work with, and so the company would not give me a refund or anything like that. So obviously you guys understand I do have to make up that cost. So I'm selling those books without the page numbers and without the writing on the spine, you know, at cost basically, and then you just pay for shipping. So the ones without page numbers, they are $14.50 on the website. I'll link that below. And then the ones that do have page numbers and writing on the spine, and these ones are $21.95, and I'll link those below as well. Again, if you have any questions, just let me know. Make sure to follow me over on Instagram. That's where you'll see all of my awesome hiking adventures. And again, if you are into hiking here in Oregon, make sure to buy this book. You have until December 19th to order to get it by Christmas. So if you want this by Christmas, just make sure to order it by December 19th, and I will make sure to get it out. I think the latest day I can ship is the 20th. So you have to get your orders in by end of day on the 19th, and I can get these out to you by Christmas. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next adventure.